We just finished part two. And I know that some of you are so overwhelmed with the amount of numbers I showed you. Please, it's very important that you understand that I presented the calculation step by step to teach you how to make the AHP calculations without any tool. Of course, that in real life, you will use a spreadsheet in Excel that will do all the hard work for you. But remember, if you don't understand the process, you cannot even defend the reasoning behind your decisions. Right now, let's take a quick journey on what we saw in this part of the course. We first created a problem, then the subsets of the problem. We developed the features of a great solution and came up with the set of criteria to be used. After that, we compared this criteria. This was where the math started. We also evaluated the consistency of our analysis. And after that, we created the alternatives. Alternatives are the options to meet that criteria and solve the problem. For the fruit diet, we decided that grapefruit, pineapple, and melon would be our options. We then compared the alternatives in each criteria. Remember that we compared the fruits used in our diet regarding their benefits, their durability, price, and taste. And by doing that, we created a set of tables comparing all alternatives against each criteria. Finally, we combined the preferences for the criteria with the preferences of each alternative in that criteria. The final result is our preference. And the sum of all results for all alternatives must add up to 1 or 100%. For example, in the case of the fruit diet, the grapefruit was the best option with an overall score of 0.557, or 55.7%. This score shows that the grapefruit is more than twice better than the second option, the melon, that is scored 0.235, or 23.5%. Again, don't be scared with the math. It's not hard, and you will get used to it. It's just a lot of numbers. But with a basic spreadsheet, you will do a very nice job.